The Browns take on the Jets on Sunday at First Energy Stadium, Mary Kay Cabot. And the best news for the Browns, 5 of the next 6 games at home, so they finally get paid back a little bit for that road-heavy schedule to begin the season. And let's start with the Jets front. They've got some guys led by Leonard Williams, who's got 5 sacks, 13 quarterback hits. They aren't ranked highly in sacks this year, but they can get after the quarterback.
Yeah, and you know what? That makes a huge difference when you have a reshuffled offensive line like the Browns have. We still don't even know for sure if Cam Irving is going to be 100% to start in there at center. And, you know, there's a lot going on at other places on that offensive line with the guards and everything. So definitely that's going to be a key to this game, is Josh getting the ball out quickly and them protecting him.
And, of course, anytime you talk about the Jets defense, you talk about Darrell Revis. And, of course, we know that matchup this week, Darrell Revis against Terrell Pryor.
Terrell is so excited for this matchup. They're both from Pittsburgh. He really wants to match wits against someone who's been to so many Pro Bowls, been around for so long, and is arguably a future Hall of Famer. He's so excited about this. You know, we'll see. Some people up in New York say that Darrell has lost a step, lost it a little bit. Terrell's been watching the film. He does not believe that.
Yeah, Terrell wasn't having any of that. The other thing about the Jets, very good against the run. They are 2nd in the NFL against the rush this season. They gave up 6 rushing yards to the Baltimore Ravens last week, so they can stop the run. On the other side of the football, it's back to Ryan Fitzpatrick for the New York Jets.
Yeah, and you know what? You know, it's been kind of crazy. Geno Smith goes down with the ACL. Ryan Fitzpatrick is back, and he came out and ripped the whole organization. I asked Todd Bowles about that the other day, and he said it hasn't been a tumultuous week. So in the span of 2 weeks, he had 9 interceptions. So he's got 11 on the season. Most of those came in 2 games. So there are opportunities there.
And he's got a pretty good receiver as well in Brandon Marshall. And how about this? Quincy Inunua has stepped in for Eric Decker. He's actually leading the team in receptions. Running the ball, Matt Forte, 2 100-yard rushing games this season, including 1 last week. In both of those games, he's carried the ball 30 times. So if the Jets can get a lead, Matt Forte seems like a guy who can protect it.
Yeah, and obviously the Browns have struggled stopping the run all season long. Last week they gave up 271 yards. It hurts to even say it. 559 total. So they've got to shut down Matt Forte.
All right. We'll see what happens on Sunday. We'll have full coverage of that game. Kickoff is at 1 p.m. Cleveland.com/Browns.